And the issue of IS-39, I think, will remain controversial. We already have a situation, a very peculiar situation, that IS-39 has still not been adopted by banks. In the case of power sector also, we have certain exemptions continuing, like in the case of derivative accounting or embedded derivatives not being separated. So there are these exceptions, I think, will continue as I see in the foreseeable future. My personal opinion or suggestion to the Institute is really to, you know, take some steps so that we move towards more compliance to the IFRS. I know it's very tough. It's very difficult. The Institute has been trying to do that, but I think more steps are required because what is happening is that 10 years ago, Pakistan was one of those countries which was very close to compliance with the IFRS. We were one of the early adopters, you know, when IAS came. From late 70s, we started adopting IAS. But I think in substance, what has happened is because of the non-compliance by a very major and critical sector, like banking sector, which is not following the global standards, and also this power sector, we are moving away from the global standards, which in my opinion is not good sign. I know there are practical problems, there are issues, very difficult to convince our friends, but I think we need to take steps as a profession that, you know, we should not move away from the global standards and best practices. No standards will be perfect. We will always be, I mean, there were issues with the IS-39, there will be issues with IFRS-9, and there are other parts of the IS-39 which are under development. So the point is that it's not that whether the standards are perfect or not. Standards will never be perfect. The point is that whatever the framework is, we have to adopt the framework completely. That is the point that our regulators and some of our friends who are not supporting compliance with the IFRS is missing. That, you know, while IS-39 may have deficiencies, but the entire world virtually adopted IS-39, you know. Similarly, other standards may have issues. But, you know, you mentioned one thing that IFRS or accounting standards are there to give you the score. You know, people should not take business decisions based on that. But actually, we have seen in one sector, people coming and telling us that, look, we took these decisions because these standards were there. So I mean, we have some arguments sometimes like that, which are not, I think, tenable. Last comment I would like to, I think you also covered in your presentation this Sharia compliance. I think this is also important. And I remember, I think, there are a number of seminars in Dubai where we were together. And one of these seminars, I don't know, you talked about this Saudi gentleman who asked a question. There was a Saudi gentleman who asked me a question on this. And same, I think, seminar, Paul Pector was also there. He asked me what do you think about the Islamic accounting standards? You know? So my answer to that was that, frankly speaking, I was very blunt and candid that we don't need Islamic accounting standards, because the thing is, the accounting standards are neither Islamic nor un-Islamic. The accounting standards are just scorekeeping. They just give you the results of the business that you have conducted. Whether or not you're Sharia compliant, that will be determined by your Sharia advisor or the auditors or whatever. That is the way you do your business. I don't know why we are getting into this Islamic accounting standards, which continues to create more and more confusion. and you know, they're not needed. As far as IFRS are concerned, they are neutral. I mean, they are not tainted by any religion. They are just giving you the results of the performance that you have achieved, you know, based on your business. So I thought I'll just mention my view on that. With that, once again, I think I would like to congratulate Yusuf, and I would also like to congratulate the audience for coming in such a large number. Professionals, this is a very important seminar, and also I'll congratulate the organizers for arranging this type of seminar. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Asa Saab. I would request you to stay here, and I would also like to invite Chairman Southern Regional Committee to come on the stage. As per our custom, I would like now like to invite Yusuf to come ahead and receive our token of appreciation. Now I would like to request as Chairman SRC Adnan Mufti to present token of appreciation to Mr. Asaduddin Shah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. On behalf of the Regional Committee, I propose a vote of thanks for a very excellent deliberated presentations by Mr. Yusuf Hassan, and as rightly said by the session chairman, it is one of the finest presentations that we have seen in the institute for a very long time, and the peculiar and the technical questions that were put forward to the speaker speaks volumes of the interest that the presentation had generated, and sir, we are thankful to you, and rightly so, he deserves a big round of applause from all of us again. We are also thankful to Mr. Asad Ali Shah, past president, for chairing the session and for his valuable comments in the conclusion. Before I invite you to dinner, and I think it's overdue, I believe, just to remind you that for poetry lovers, the Southern Region Committee has organized a Mushaira at the Arts Council on 26th of November, that is Saturday, and you can always, the card stall is placed outside, so you can really get registrations at the desk. Thank you, and please join us for dinner.